Before we get to the main part of this episode, let's quickly cover something I've been meaning to mention. You may have noticed that, at the end of the last episode, when we completed Gaul and Maia's Citadel and collected the final power cell of the game, our total was actually 101 power cells, rather than simply 100. There's actually a pretty interesting reason for this. It involves the Precursor Basin back in the Rock Village area, and in particular, the beat record time on the Gorge challenge. To activate this challenge, you first had to talk to the gambler in Rock Village, then in Precursor Basin you had to beat a record time of 45 seconds to get your power cell. However, there is a bug associated with this event that can prevent you from getting the power cell. If you fail the challenge on your first attempt, then talk to the gambler again before reattempting it, there is a chance that the timer will read 0.01 seconds, making the record time impossible to beat. When this happens, the only thing to do is switch to a different save file or restart. However, to get around this glitch, the developers added one extra power cell to the game for 101, but kept 100% completion requirement at 100 power cells, meaning that if you triggered the gambler glitch, you could still achieve full completion and get the full ending of the game, even if you couldn't get the record time power cell in Precursor Basin. And now, with that out of the way, let's get to the main part of this episode. Hello, everybody! This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome back to the Jak and Daxter playthrough. In our last episode, we explored the final level of the game, Gaul and Maia's Citadel, and we were able to conquer its challenges, and we added 5 more power cells to our total. We now have 101 power cells overall for 100% completion. We have collected everything in the game, all 2,000 precursor orbs, all the power cells, all 112 scout flies. For all intents and purposes, the game is complete. However, although Gaul and Maia's Citadel has been conquered, Gaul and Maia themselves, well, we still have to deal with them. They have managed to activate a giant precursor robot, and now we have to stop them from using it to destroy the world. So, from the top of Gaul and Maia's Citadel, where we rescued the Green Sage, go inside this chamber, and once we step on this elevator, it'll be time for the final confrontation. Here we go. This is going to be the finale, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to finish off this playthrough, finally. So here we are at the top of the Citadel, and right over there is the Precursor Robot, and it is trying to open that Dark Eco Silo. We cannot allow that to happen. That Dark Eco Silo opens, we can kiss the world goodbye. So let's get some Eco, and let's go. So this is it, folks. This is our final test, our final boss, in a game where bosses aren't that much of a factor, but trust me, this is going to be quite a confrontation. The first thing you want to do is collect the yellow eco, and then you'll want to go into first person mode and shoot the eye of the precursor robot. Once this happens, collect some blue eco and make your way across to the precursor launcher and go up. And that's the first phase of the fight. Every phase is going to end with a bomb being launched, and you have to use the precursor launcher to launch yourself off of the arena before the bomb goes off. If that bomb goes off, it's an instant kill, and when you die at any point in this fight, it is back to the beginning. So you need to be on your guard. However, the precursor robot is not that much of a challenge. This second phase, you will face lurkers that are spawned from the Dark Eco. Simply take them out with the yellow eco and you'll be okay. And once again, get the blue eco, make your way to the launcher, and up you go. Seriously, do not be caught in that bomb's explosion. But as you can see, the Eco Silo is opening anyway. And as the fight goes on, this hole will be bigger and bigger, so you need to be way more cautious about the middle of the arena. And now for this phase, these bombs are going to go off that launch shockwaves. Use your jump and your spin attack in midair to avoid the shockwaves. Now just simply get the yellow eco and shoot the arm until it's broken off. And once again, blue eco time. So I'll admit, I had a very hard time the first time I fought the Precursor robot, but now that I've got it down, it's really not that hard. You just simply have to avoid the attacks, and when your opening comes, launch an attack of your own. Now for pretty much the next phase, simply avoid the giant projectile from the cannon, and then shoot back when you have an opening. Let's go! This is still a pretty epic fight, though. I mean, you got the Dark Eco here. You've got a giant robot out to get you. I mean, this is still a pretty epic finale, in my opinion. And it is pretty fun. All right! Alright, this is the final phase, but for this one we have to wait for an item to appear. Bombs are about to go off, but don't worry, we got this in the bag, right here! Well, that was anticlimactic.
Well, it looks like I may have been too hard on you boys. You do have what it takes to be heroes.
But Daxter, now we can't change you back.
Don't worry about me, baby. You know what they say. Big things come in small packages.
Jak? You have an incredible talent for channeling eco. Samos, you may have been right about this one after all.
And Kira, without your help and ingenuity, none of this would have been possible. Perhaps we've found another sage now that Gaul and Maia are lost.
Yes, Gaul and Maia. The Dark Eco probably destroyed them. Probably.
Who cares? Bring him on! We can take him again! Right, Jak? I said, right, Jak? Wow! Put it on ice, big guy!
And that's your game, ladies and gentlemen. That is Jak and Daxter, the Precursor Legacy. So, that's it! That is essentially it for the playthrough as a whole, and I have to say, although it was difficult at times to really get this playthrough going, I know there have been gaps in the uploads and stuff, but this was still a fun game to play through. I said it at the start, this is one of my favorite games from the PlayStation 2 era, and it is one of my favorite 3D platformers of all time. I mean, I love platforming games in general. I mean, I grew up in the era of the 3D platformer. Mario 64, Banjo-Kazooie, Spyro the Dragon, and this game. So this stands still as one of my favorite 3D platformers of all time, and I am glad that I was able to get a playthrough in for it, for the channel. Gaul, voiced by Dee Snider. Actually, there's a pretty fun tidbit about Dee Snider voicing Gaul. I ought to get this out while I can. sometimes during the boss battle, against the Precursor robot, Gaul will actually have a line, "We're not gonna take it," which is a reference to a song by Twisted Sister, which Dee Snider is frontman for. But anyway, going through the voice actors here, the voice acting, you know, pretty good, all things considered for a game like this. And, I mean, this is just a really well-made, well-put-together game. I mean, I wouldn't say by any means it's perfect, but this is a game where a lot of things come together and a lot of things click. I mean, level design, gameplay, you know, controls, graphics. This game still looks pretty good. I mean, and I guess it's because it goes with the cartoonish, the cartoony kind of graphics and stuff. It still looks pretty good. I mean, it shows its age being from the early PlayStation 2 era, even, you know, remastered for the PS3, because this is on the Jak and Daxter PS3 collection. But even so, this game still holds up pretty well for me. And again, maybe it's just a nostalgia and everything, because I did grow up with this game and games of its ilk. And really, if you kind of think about it, this is kind of a game that's sort of, I don't know, I don't mean to get all philosophical here, but in some ways this game kind of symbolizes the time it came from. You know, early 2001, pre-9/11, when times were a little more innocent, if you were. A more innocent time in my life, because I was still a kid when this game came out. And this game kind of had that sort of lighthearted, happy-go-lucky feel. And then comes Jak 2, where it gets all really dark and serious, but still maintains the humor and stuff a little bit. You know, post-9/11, I don't know, you could look at it that way. Maybe I'm just talking out of nothing, but still, that's kind of how I look at this game. A symbol of a more innocent time in my life. And I guess that's why I still love it so much. Not just because it's still a good game, but because of that reason too. But I guess at this point, I'm sure someone may be wondering if I'm going to do any of the other Jak and Daxter games. The answer is, I'm undecided. I have been playing Jak 2, but that game, I'm liking it, but it frustrates me sometimes. Jak and Daxter is a much more difficult game than Jak and Daxter 1. It's a lot more challenging, especially with the increased focus on combat and stuff over just platforming. So while I am enjoying Jak 2 and I am past the halfway point of that game, I'm above 50% completion, I find myself frustrated with it sometimes because of the higher challenge level and the increased combat. I mean, Jak 2 can be a tough nut to crack in certain areas, but it's not that I don't like it. I am liking it, but I'm not sure if I can deliver a playthrough of it at this current time. And I can't say anything about Jak 3, because I haven't actually played Jak 3 yet. I am trying to get through Jak 2 before I get to Jak 3. I believe in doing games in order. So I can't really say anything about Jak 3 at this point, but definitely for Jak 2 at the moment, I'd like to do a playthrough, but I don't know if I can do one at this current time. So, we should be getting to the end of the credit sequence here, and actually, we're going to keep going after the end of the credit sequence, because when you achieve 100% completion of this game, you actually get an extra cutscene. The cutscene we got before the credits start after beating Gaul and Maia, that plays no matter what, but when you get full completion, there's an extra segment that sets up Jak 2. So, we gotta stay with it here until everything is all said and done with. But for all intents and purposes, this playthrough is done. That awkward moment where you kind of don't know what to say anymore. I mean, I know it's bad form as a Let's Player to not have anything to say, but really, you know, it's the end of the game, and I'm not so sure if I can skip these credits, so I think we still have to kind of keep going with it. We're going through the localization testers for all the European countries for Sony Computer Entertainment Europe. But, I mean, again, overall, you know, it wasn't easy for me to put together the playthrough at times, and I'm sure for those of you that tried to follow it, it wasn't easy either. But we should be getting to the end of the credits, and here we go.
Holy Yakov! What could that be?
Wow! It's an ancient precursor door! It looks like it will only open if we fill all 100 holes with power cells.
We're heroes, remember? We have 100 power cells.
Technically, we have 101, but we'll go with it. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. One last look at the Naughty Dog logo. Naughty Dog put together a great game. One of their first games after Crash Bandicoot. And this was a dandy one, I gotta tell you. Very enjoyable game. If anyone that has not played this themselves, you want a good 3D platformer from the early PS2 era, I highly recommend checking out this game. This is a good one. And I guess now it's time for the farewells. So, once again, I know it wasn't easy following this playthrough, but those of you that did follow this playthrough all the way through and you were able to keep up with it, I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did enjoy it, be sure to say so in the comments. I would appreciate it. And if you did follow it, I hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully I was able to deliver a playthrough that did this game justice. This is one of my favorite games of the early PS2 era. And I guess the only thing to say is that's a wrap on the Jak and Daxter playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw in this video and you liked the playthrough overall, be sure to like, leave a comment, and tell me what you think. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next playthrough and the next video. See you folks later.